These weary travellers are setting out on the last leg of a very special journey. They're returning a sacred Iman artefact which was stolen from their country 45 years ago. As day breaks on their camp and they start the journey into town, they share an emotional moment.
And thank you so, so much for doing this to the Iman. And thank you so much for doing this for our country. Thank you. Thank you. Walk well, walk strong, walk together. Thank you.
Johnny Danalis and his team have walked 500 kilometres to return the Star of Taroom, a significant grinding stone, which has been sitting in a Brisbane backyard. It's been something his family have been waiting to do for years.
Dad used to talk about returning the grindstone, but it kind of never happened. And then in 2019, Dad was diagnosed with cancer. And we had a serious discussion about taking one last road trip together to return the stone back to the property, Bethany property. Before we knew it, the cancer had taken over and Dad was gone within 5 months of being diagnosed. And the Star of Taroom sat in his backyard.
After his father's passing, Johnny decided he wanted to walk the star back to Taroom.
I just thought, well, we could load this stone onto a truck or a ute and bring it back to country. It'd take 5 or 6 hours and, you know, it'd be a nice thing to do, but I thought, how could we actually put this star, this artifact to work?
He wants to raise awareness about the importance of returning artefacts to country. So he got in touch with Iman elders, who couldn't believe what they were hearing.
Well, we just thought, oh, we'd bring it back in a truck or a car. But when he said, oh, no, we want to walk it back, I said, you got to be joking. I said, what, are you crazy or something? I said, no, sure. We feel in our hearts that we need to show people that, well, you can return things back on country that belong to traditional owners.
And he's been joined by plenty of people along the way, including elders who've guided the star through their country and decided to stay on, and young Iman mob who feel the star has guided them back home.
So I'm proud to be back on my home country, and I'm really proud to lead it home.
Those involved in the journey say it has been life-changing.
I don't know how I'm going to walk away from it now, because the tie and the bind between the group that set out until today is very strong. It's a very strong connection there.
It's an incredible honour to be part of something like this. We never dreamed it would get this big.
They hope the story of the star's return encourages others to bring forward any artefacts they may have in their homes.
The stone coming home to its rightful place is very healing. I know it's very healing for me. And I also really hope that it encourages other people around this country, if they have stuff that doesn't belong to them, they should give it back as well.
And that has already begun, with one person hearing about Johnny's journey and deciding to come forward with stones that had been taken from the same area at the same time as the Star of Taroom. These stones have been dubbed the Turtle of Taroom. The star and the turtle will now be housed at a new purpose-built keeping place.
We've had that painted. We had our totems, you know, put in there, ready for the Star of Taroom, and our pictures, our stories. We've got 3,000 to 4,000 artefacts, little ones to go in there that's been tagged over the years. And that'll be our keeping place.
Auntie Heather's family has lived away from Iman country for many years, like many Iman mob who were driven from their home. She often visits her country and says the Star of Taroom has encouraged others to return home, many for the first time.
I looked up to the sky and I said to my father, you know, the artefact has come home and it's brought us, I think it's brought us all together.
Iman people hope the interest in the star continues and many more mob come to see this very special part of their history.
I hope it helps them link up with mob they haven't talked to in years, or find family they haven't heard from in years. I hope it, you know, through all the sadness, I hope it, they can get joy from something being returned to country, knowing that their ancestors sat around that stone, they created that stone.
I just want healing between the Yemen people and the landowners and the community, because I think that's the way forward for us.